وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال. وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد. إن شاء الله تعالى today we're going to have a test on the كتاب الأجهمية. And of course the sharh as well, because we did study the sharh. The questions are not only coming from the matin of Al-Jumia, it's also coming from the sharh of Muhammad ibn Uddin Abdul Hamid, the Kitab Tuhfatu Saniya, sharh Muqaddimat Al-Jumia. Muhammad ibn Uddin Abdul Hamid placed in there some extra benefits that are in there. And we inshallah ta'ala are going to do that test. So everyone who is watching, so we're going to do that test, inshallah ta'ala. Anyone who's watching, bi-idhnillahi al-kareem, try to answer these questions as they are on the board. The questions are all on the board. Every time we're going to wipe off the questions off the board, we're going to put extra questions on. So inshallah ta'ala, let's go over each question, bi-idhnillahi al-kareem, what it means. I'll explain it to you all. Then I'll wipe it off, and then I'll put the second question. And then at the end, I'll give you the answers, and everybody will mark the other person next to them, or you will pass over each person's notes, and you will mark, inshallah ta'ala, fairly and justly. So let's go over each one. So the first question is, ما هو الكلام لغة واصطلاحا؟ What is kalam? What is kalam? The first question is, if you don't know, if your Arabic is not that strong, some words you don't understand what it means, you can just write in English quickly, inshallah ta'ala. Ma huwa al-kalam? What is speech, lughatan, linguistically, and istilahan, technically? So what does kalam mean, linguistically or technically? So I want a linguistic definition from you, and I want a technical definition. And I don't want anyone looking at their notes. There's no one who's allowed to look at their notes. Number two, ما معنى كون الكلام لفظا? What does it mean? What does it mean? A speech being a lafz. What does it mean? When a speech is lafz, what does it mean? ما معنى كونه مركبا? What does it mean that a speech has to be مركب? Okay. The third, fourth one is ما معنى كونه مفيدا. What does it mean, it being مفيد? What does that mean? Number five, ما معنى كونه بالوضع? What does it mean that it has to be by وضع? What does that actually mean? And the sixth one is, كم أقسام الكلام? How many types is speech categorized into? Remember when I ask you كم, all you just need to tell me is the number. You don't have to give me what they are. I always ask you after that what they are. Okay? Because all of these are questions, I didn't put a question mark at the end, by the way, okay? So if you don't see a question mark, everyone knows it's a question. ما هي الكلام? ما هي? So what is it? Here I wrote, كم أقسام الكلام? And here I said, ما هي? What is it? So what are they now? Now you need to tell them what they are. ما هو الاسم لغة واصطلاحا? What is اسم linguistically and technically? What does the word اسم لغة mean? And what does اسم اصطلاحا mean technically? إلى كم قسم ينقسم الاسم? How many types is the ism categorized into? Okay, ma hiya, what are they? What are these types? Then I said, ma huwa al-dhahir? What does dhahir mean? Ma huwa al-mudmar? What does mudmar mean? What does mudmar mean? So each one, you have to write it in Arabic, an explanation. So I wrote in Arabic, you have to? So break it down. Whatever language, Arabic that you use, even if it's weak, even if it's not strong, even if you're trying your best to say it, if you have to sometimes fill in with English words here and there, because you can't articulate here, la bas, inshallah, we'll accept it for now. But you have to try to say it in Arabic. Okay? Because remember, when we studied it, we took it from the kitab. So inshallah, can I rub it off and write the, has everybody written it? Which question? Huh? This, which one here? Number 10. Number 10 is ما هي what are they? So here remember I said إلى كم قسم, how many types does a speech categorize, ism categorize into? How many types? I said that right, how many types? Is that what? I said كم? How many? قسم, how many types does a ism categorize into? So you just have to give me a number. Here you just give me a number, 5, 6, 7, 8, whatever you want. But here you have to tell me what they are now. You can't just say them. Remember, we categorize ism into types. You write the figure here, and then here you write what they are. Okay? And then here I asked you, ما هو الظاهر? What's ظاهر? What does it mean? And here I wrote, ما هو المضمر? What does مضمر actually mean? Okay? Can somebody rub it off, inshallah ta'ala? بارك الله فيك. Nah, take the numbers away. Okay, what was the last number that we wrote? Huh? 12, right? So 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. 22. Okay, and then here, question 13, I ask, ما هو المبهم? What is مبهم? ما هو المبهم? What is مبهم? Number 14, ما هو الفعل لغة واصطلاحة? What's a verb linguistically and technically? إلى كم قسم ينقسم الفعل? How many types is a verb categorized into? You have to just mention the figures. Number 16, ما هي? What are they? Number 17, ما تعريف الماضي? What's the definition of a ماضي? Number 18, ما تعريف المضارع? What's the definition of a مضارع? Okay, ما تعريف الأمر? What's the definition of a أمر? ما هو الحرف لغة واصطلاحة? What's a حرف linguistically and technically? إلى كم ينقسم الحرف? How many types is a حرف categorized into? أذكرها مع التعريف. Each of the types that you mention here, you have to give their definition as well with it. So here you just have to mention the figures. So you just say, مثلا, five, six. So when you mention, for example, five here, for example, and here you go and you mention the five, you know, you say the five that they are. You mention the five, you give each one a definition what it means. Okay? أذكرها مع التعريف. You have to define each one. Okay? Number 23, ما هي علامات الاسم? What are the signs of a noun? What are the signs of a noun? Yeah, do ta'bir. Do your own ta'bir, yeah, no problem. As long as we know where you're coming from. And we'll correct your ta'bir as well, inshallah. Okay, so well, how many questions have you written? Have you written all of this side? This side? The last one. Okay, just take off. Okay, what was it? You know what I'll do? At the end, I'll explain each question again. Yeah? Yeah, that's it.
تقريبا 100 I don't think anyone's going to leave out till 11. We read the last one. You haven't got even got to Babel, Arabia, it's the Muqaddima. Based on these questions, you're going to rewrite Ajrumi again. With each question, when you write it, Ajrumi has been written. And the Tuhfat al-Saniya. Because I taught you all of this, didn't I not? Yeah, I taught you all of this. It's been going over for over 3 months now, taqriban, sah? Yeah? 3 months. I hope that 3 months, the energy didn't go to waste. Yeah, Abbas, sah? I hope so, ya Abbas. Inshallah. Yeah? Nah, I'll just use this one. I'll just use this one with you guys. Thank you. guess I shouldn't have rubbed that side off, yeah? Huh? Was I wrong not to? Or did I? Sure. Yeah? SubhanAllah, I didn't. Yeah, I didn't. I shouldn't have rubbed it out, yeah? You didn't write it? So did you write this side? Did you write? You wrote this side? Which one? That part that was going in? Okay, SubhanAllah. Doing a lafthin. Yeah, it's هل تختص باء القسم بدخول على لفظ دون لفظ. Each one I'll explain. Don't worry, I've got my notes here. I'll just read it for you guys and I'll explain it. But I think we should just focus on writing now. Okay. I hope you're enjoying yourself so far. That's the muqaddimah. That's now Bab al-I'rab starts. All of that 38 questions was just the introduction. What we did, remember the beginning. The chapter of I'rab starts after that, inshallah ta'ala. Allah said in the Quran, Inna sanulqi alayka qawlan thaqila. Muhammad, we're going to give you a speech that's very strong. So you have to learn grammar. Okay, let me explain each one, inshallah ta'ala, each question. Where was it when I last stopped explaining? Yeah? So what was the question? Read the question. So I said, ما هو المبهم? What is مبهم? What does it mean? So you need to explain what مبهم means. ما هو الفعل لغة واصطلاحا? What's a فعل linguistically and technically? What is it? إلى كم قسم? How many types? ينقسم الفعل does the verb, is it categorized into? ما هي? So you just have to give a number. Whenever I ask you كم, you just need to tell the number. But then after that, I always say ما هي? What is it? Then I said, ما تعريف الماضي? What's the definition of a madi, past tense? I shouldn't have told you. ما تعريف المضارع? What's the definition of a مضارع? ما تعريف الأمر? What is the definition of أمر? ما هو الحرف لغة واصطلاحا? What's حرف لغة? And what is it اصطلاحا? إلى كم ينقسم الحرف? How many types is a حرف broken into? You just need to give the number.
اذكرها مع التعريف. Now you need to tell me each one with a definition. Okay? Okay. ما هي علامات الاسم؟ ما هي علامات الاسم؟ What are the signs of a noun? What are the signs of a ism? ما هي الخفض لغة واصطلاحا؟ What is خفض لغة واصطلاحا؟ What does it mean? Okay. ما هو التنوين لغة واصطلاحا؟ What does تنوين لغة mean? And what does it mean اصطلاحا؟ على أي شيء تدل حروف الجر؟ حروف الجر, what do they show? Like for example, من, إلى, عن, على, في, رب, با, كاف, لام. All of them are حروف الخفض, right? What do they all show? Each one, you need to tell me what they mean. Each of the حروف الخفض, each one, what does it mean? What does من mean? Okay, what does it show? What does إلى show? What does عن show? What does على show? What does في show? What does رب show? What does باب show? والكاف. And what does لام show? You need to know all the حروف الخفض anyways. Each one you take and you tell me what they are, what they mean. Of course, you say in Arabic. ما هي حروف القسم؟ What is حروف القسم? What are they? Okay. ما الذي تختص واو القسم بالدخول عليه من أنواع الأسماء? Which of the nouns is the واو القسم specific to? The واو القسم, which type of noun is it specific to? The next question is, هل تختص باء القسم? The باء القسم, is it specific to a wording over another word? تختص بلفظ دون لفظ, is it specific to a particular لفظ over another لفظ? Is it? ما هي علامات الفعل? What are the علامات of the فعل? إلى كم قسم تنقسم علامات الفعل? How many types are the فعل categorized into? You just need to tell me the number. ما هي وراضي؟ ما علامتان المختصان بالماضي؟ Okay. What are the two signs that are specific to the ماضي? Specific to the ماضي. ما هي العلامتان المختصان بالمضارع؟ What are the two signs that are specific to the مضارع؟ ما هي العلامة المشتركة بين الماضي والمضارع؟ What are the signs that are shared between the ماضي and the مضارع؟ اذكر ما تدل عليه قد من المعاني. Explain to us what meanings does قد actually indicate. What meaning does قد indicate? You need to tell us it. Okay. ما معنى seen وسوف? What do seen and سوف mean? What do they show? Okay. Of course, you need to tell us the difference by explaining. So you can't tell both of them the same thing. ما هي علامة الأمر? What's the signs of an أمر? Last but not least, بماذا يتميز الحرف عن أخويه الاسم والفعل? What is a حرف distinct and unique in from its two brothers? اسم and a حرف. اسم and a فعل. The حرف, what is it distinct with? Over the اسم and the فعل.
Why was Mahi and Alamat
Mustafa? Huh? Huh? I didn't mention Mahu Alamat and Mustafa Nibil Mudari? Mustafa Bina? Okay, JazakAllah for mentioning that.
Mm-hmm.